You'll at least know what the main rules are. The rules for your head is your head looks where you're going, looks at your target. So if I'm going to Chadwick, I go like that. You're in trouble. No. If I'm turning to go that way, you look where you're about to go. It's very common for people to look the wrong way, like to look that way, for example, when they're turning this way. You always look the direction that you're about to go. You're looking at your target and how you're going to get there. The other, you will be on, boom, and boom, and boom. Notice I'm leaning forward on the back sweep. Boom, boom. Your goal is maximum boat rotation on each stroke. A little bit of bow going under. So just a little bit of edge. This helps with your blunts and your roundhouses. So Simon, you're in here, you're doing a backstroke. You're right here and you're, so it's all about rotating. Rotating. There you go. Straight back on. Getting all the way back here.
Okay.
All the way, and then boom. Now this time. Boom. Slower. Boom. Alright. Good. Okay. Now you're focused. That's good on the strokes. Now your focus is two things. Lean forward. Boom. Lean forward. Lean.
Okay.
And rotate the boat a lot. Wow, there it is. Whoa, there it is. Whoa, good. Okay, so on stop. Anybody sweating yet or a little hot?
Oh yeah.
Yeah, good. Done with stroke drills for right now, I think. Let's do a couple more warmer uppers that I would do, and then we'll do a little stretching, and then we'll do some rolling, and then we'll go surf. So, who works on a computer? Alright, so when you're on a computer, you're like this. And these muscles in your neck, between your neck and your shoulder. Have you ever looked in the mirror and you go like this? And you see a sharp line down your neck into your shoulder? Or You stretch, you ever notice?
Uh-huh.
Raise your hand if yes. You've never seen that before? Well, then you haven't looked. You gotta get a mirror, and you gotta go like this, stretch your neck a little bit, go stretch them, and you'll see a line.
Thank you.
To 60 degrees, you push hard and you lift your legs. And the idea, by leaning forward and lifting your legs, you're here, the boat is there, and it just stops rotation and maintains and falls. From this position, if you're going to land too flat, you just do that with your feet. You push the bow down. If you're going to land too steep, you go forward a little more and lift the bow up. But the point is, when you get off, when you push off, you're not rotating, you're just falling like this. If you're rotating in the air, you're not seal launching right. Now in this case, there is no real air. We're just kind of on the edge, and we're just gonna tip in. So your goal is to land dead vertical. Now Simon was Simon didn't quite get the bow down enough, so he hit like this. And then instead of like being able to throw over the top, he fell to the side because he didn't have enough body weight that way. So looking straight up the current, you're not to the left or right of that person.
Yep.
So if I get out here, if I'm here, you're there. We're in a line relative to the current. So follow me. We have lots of setup. It's going to be easy.
Yeah. What's the move here, Simon?
Pardon?
What's the move here?
This is Garb. You come to a tongue, point slightly to the right, and just paddle down to the right of it.
Okay.
How's it going, Spetter? Yeah. Yeah? Is it good?
Hello.
I think it's okay. I mean, like, yeah, three of them were like, kind of looking at something.
Stay a little right here.
Yeah, right down the middle of this wave tree.
You going next? You going next? Go. There we go. we go.
Turn around.
I did that time. Much more relaxed when I stayed in, yeah.
Sit like you're sitting on a chair.
Is that what he said?
Yeah. Oh, man, he got surfed all the way up.
Oh, he got clipped. Baby Jesus, the hell am I doing? So where's my whirlpool at? Center or right?
Huh?
The center of the rock or right?
This side of the rock.
Okay.
In between the hole and the rock.
Yeah.
Where Simon went. Okay. Simon totally, I'm like, come on, you got it. He totally turned his head down and bailed. He had that head easy.
Cool.
He will be scolded for that one. Like, you know, in situations like this where we're practicing, you don't know what you're capable of if you bail on stuff.
Yeah.
What if that was the big waterfall on the rocks and you die? And you, in a spot that you, even if you screwed it up and didn't make it, had to go through whatever.
Yeah.
It's almost no consequence of trying and not making it. By trying and hard moves and spots that are low consequence, you learn what you're capable of. So you don't just wait till you get to a spot that's a must-made move, otherwise it's serious danger, to see if you can do it. You practice in low danger spots, hard moves. So you try to make hard class 4 moves in class 2 or
okay.
Stuff like that. So anyway, we're gonna get to that, Eddie, and just peel out in between those close to that rock as we can.
Touch the rock with
your paddle when you go by.
Ooh.
I'm drifting.
Go down?
Take it down. Yeah. Look okay. Over and roll up.
Just anywhere? Okay.
Over to the shore, super drive side up. favored pocket, trying to get set up, get things working for him. He wants to find the plow, get that nice green pass. He's coming down backwards on the side. Nice. Snappy, snappy, snappy. Sorry, back blunt. 10 seconds left for Travis. One more ride, final pass. Time is running out, and there it is for Travis Lamy. As he goes to the end, he goes to right after the buzzer. I think the buzzer went, unfortunately, before he threw the air screw there.
Dropping down right away. Let's see what he's got. Kind of on that first pass. As he comes down, going to go for a nice big one. Lamy on there, going for the left in the angular direction. I think I saw some air under that one as he goes for a spin to the right. Coming down, looking for that last pass, spin to the right. Into a
All right, first up in our second heat here is Mr. Luke Pomeroy wearing big number 7, lucky number 7 on the water.
I like to move it, move it. You like to move it. I like to.
All right, Sammy catching the wave here as he moves himself onto the shoulder. Coming down nice air screw. He's trying to do a little bit of a flip turn there. Coming down. Close the air screw in the other direction. See what else he's got for us as he comes down. Nice big air down to the left.
One more move.
He's only got a few seconds left. Let's see what else he's got for us. That'll be it for Sammy Duff first try.
Show me a good roll. Go under. Second set up. Give me the best hip snap, head down you got.
Ha ha!
a helmet for it. You wanna go? You going? Okay. Sorry. Yeah, okay. Time to get messed up. Oh, shit. Woo-hoo. Weird seeing you right here without grabbing your handle. It's weird seeing you here without holding on to the back of your boat.
Sounded good.
Oh, get her nose down.
You know, you go all the way to a bow stall like that, right? So the wave is behind you. Go fast, slow down, let the wave catch you, and then out it down.
Okay.
If you want to go all the way vertical, you stomp your feet. Mostly vertical. I'll give people the high sign. So maybe we'll have, maybe I'll lead Cezanne through first, and then Simon will go last, and I'll, you guys decide which order you want to go. Okay. That way you can watch, Cezanne and I go through, and then Simon can yell at you, yeah, that's good, or a little more right, or whatever. Let's head out and head down, dude.
Yeah.
See where it then hits, goes into a trough, and then up to another little peak.
Yeah.
And right behind it is two a little more subtle of the same thing. It's pretty much a valley in between those two sets of waves. You see the valley? Basically,
yeah.
Two humps with a low spot all the way through. You just paddle through the low spot, and you should be more or less in the middle of the tongue. All right, remember we talked about broad external focus, right? The lead into that, those waves don't try to tip you. They're not hard to paddle through. You don't sprint, so it's not head down. You're gonna paddle like this. Nice and easy, relaxed. And you're looking downstream. When I say look downstream, not like this. Look downstream like this. That's scanning left and right. You're scanning over that horizon line. When you get past that second wave, you'll be close enough to see the right and left side. You'll start coming and you'll see right side fills, left side fills, and a tongue. If you are a foot to the left of the middle, turn right a little bit and work your way to the middle. If you don't have a broad external focus, you're just gonna charge and just be like, fuck, I hope I'm in the middle, and have no idea. So how do you get into broad external focus? The way you get in broad external focus is you start in the eddy and you go like this. You read the logo on your boat. Seals, Korean 17. Ooh, wispy clouds. Ooh, feel a bit of a breeze. We're in shade. It's sunny over there. Oh, there's some birds flying. That's a broad external focus. That's the focus you paddle through the rapid. If you have an internal monologue going on at all, that's an internal focus. That is not a broad external focus. So you start in advance, I'm going to paddle through the valley, I'm going to look for the tongue, I'm going to be in the middle of the tongue. That is all you have to do. Seeing that the paddling through the valley will put you somewhere, hopefully near the middle or at least on the edge, and you have about 3-4 seconds, maybe 3 seconds to work your way from the time you see the tongue more in the middle, that's plenty of time. 3 seconds is like this. Oh, I can see it. Oh, 2001, 2002, 2003. Or whichever direction you end up wanting to go. If you don't, broad external focus. So the way we're going to assure you have a broad external focus, I'll lead Cezanne down. I'm just going to go down. I'll be at the bottom. I'll eddy out. And I'll go like this. And, pretty standard in our class that we have to invent our own gang signs. What's your gang sign? The porn star. He hasn't even busted that move out yet. But, what's your gang sign going to be? Full push. Show me that one more time. What? Staring at the hole or the wave. I look at the shore, find Christine in the crowd. I blow her a kiss, wave. I hit the hole. I usually do maybe 10 seconds of moves. I look at the judges, make sure that before I do, like in between moves, look at the judge, broad external focus. I see a chief judge and go. People think, oh, he's being so cocky. He's like looking at people in the middle of his ride. I'm like, no, I want to win. And I need to have a broad external focus. Otherwise, I have the water in my eyes. I'm like this. And I'm just looking at the hole, I'm like, oh, nasty, instead you go like that, and the moves are easier because you're back in the right frame of mind. And what happens is otherwise, people point and shoot. They get started, you hit the first wave, and they just head down. I think I'm in the right spot, narrow focus, and don't you make any adjustments the rest of the time. And it's like, who knows? And they wonder why, and they don't know where they're at. So that's gangs, peel out, paddleboard to trough, straight downstream angle. You go through the whole valley, straight downstream. Before you get to the wave, find me. Look back, middle of the tongue. Super easy. Let me go first so that I can make sure everybody has their gang sign.
Yeah, so as you're going through troughs,
yeah,
look for the tongue. I don't think he adjusted when he went to the end there.
Okay.
Cool. He's pretty much on it. But yeah, just pull one top.
I saw the tongue, I'm like, I want to go for the hole.
Ah, cool, I like it.
you're controlling it with your little edge and it carves just like a skateboard or whatever.
Yep, that's my learning curve getting out of it.
Yeah. But you did a lot of good where you're just like real nice and you stayed in the middle.
Thank you.
Careful going over there, she's about to flush. Don't go past that foam over there. That's the plushy spot.
Okay.
Try to stay in the middle of the foam. Don't forget to look back and forth so you know where you're at.
Good point.
You go. Are you ready? Need a break?
I'm good. I'll go.
Oh, okay. Wasn't worth it, just keep in mind you voted for it.
You could have appealed. Oh yeah, it's different. So how many rapids do we have below us, Simon? Is it like four?
Pardon?
Are there like four rapids? Iron Ring, No Name, Butterfly.
Well, you've got up at No Name, Lower No Name.
Black Velvet.
You've got the ST shoot at the wrong spot.
Oh, I almost put the boat in here. That wouldn't have been... This is the better way here, yeah. Oh, that's soft. Oh my God, they're full of sand now.
next, he's going to turn one loaf of bread and one fish into lunch for all of us.
Don't notice.
on sideways. If you go like this, your boat's gonna spin. I'm gonna get a 180. You will do a spin. You will do a 180. So that the water, as long as you come in angled this way, nice! The water will do all the work. As long as you have an angle this way, if the hole disappears and the current pulls you out now. So use the water. Go out, turn this way, turn, see, very nice turn. Pull, race! You gotta let the boat turn all the way backwards, and then spin it around the other way. You're getting about to here, and then you're switching, and so you're pulling the stern under. Let it go all the way to backwards, and then switch. Pull. You don't want to hesitate backwards very long, because you get sucked in. If you do it, then you can follow. So, basically, you're going to go in, you do not charge. You don't paddle like this on the way in, you paddle like this. A lot of room to increase the speed, and then you pull off the drop. Now the key to pulling off the drop is, if this is the drop, you don't pull here and then just fall off. You get to your butt is right here, just like when we're doing the pogo flip off the dock. Right, that place, that balance point, right when you're right about there, you reach across and you pull your boat off, and you lift your knees when you're going up. You keep the bow up and just like this. So the way to the opposite of the boat is to go off like this and go.
You need to go? Or you? You want me to?
You're up there. You better come.
Sure. From our back, so that's kind of nice. that? Too close?
Okay. Yeah, you. The steep part is a little further over.
There we go.
Did he taste that beer yet?
A little bit.
It's in the air, isn't it?
Well, if hopefully, right? We'll find a way to tap that one keg, right?
Can you imagine if it rains beer? Yeah.
It may be a trash bag full of foam, but we'll find a way, right? Yeah. That's a good day. I liked that channel.
Yeah, it's nice. And we saw nobody. Not one. Not one raft, not one cut. Oh no, we saw a man and his son.
They had a boat, right?
Yeah. Walking on site. They were the only people we saw all day.
Yep.
Yeah, there wasn't even anyone at Babyface when we were surfing.
Was there any competition or anything today or not?
No.
Well, they're probably, okay, so they're all done maybe, and none of them would have done the middle channel anyway. There's less play spots, I guess, yeah?
I mean, the competitors, they all just want to paddle guard, basically. They just turn up and live at guard.
Yep.
And they tend to do it in small bursts, so they'll go for like 2 hours, go for like 2 hours paddle, and then leave
again. I get that. It's different, man, going 8 hours. You know, like, we're having full days.
Oh, yeah. It's a lot of paddling.
That's zero complaint. I'm humbled and appreciative of all the time. I'm getting better every day. So
that is why you're getting tired, because you're doing like 2 weekends worth of paddling in one day.
Oh yeah. When you do a quarter of a season or half a season of paddling in 1 week, yeah. Eric was super stoked that he got to do his nostalgic little ate a freaking clam on the beach. Scoped it out for next year, maybe, you know.
Oh, Steve loved that as well, didn't he? The clam on the beach.
Yeah, he did. I wasn't going to. I'm like, you know, I've had oysters and stuff, and I've had cooked clams. I'm like, I don't think I should eat a raw clam for the first time in the middle of nowhere, you know?
It's normally pretty fresh in the middle of nowhere.
Yeah, I'm sure it's, but you know. Okay.
look at the birds.
Yeah, you're looking around.
The rafts are getting closer.
It's more relaxing, isn't it? The only part that wasn't relaxed was
going down after this?
Sitting on that rock, I could see it. If you can't see it, get to where you can see it yourself.
That part to the right would flip you more?
Yeah, that's a deep down.
Is that a hole, would you say, right there?
to the right of the tongue?
Or not really?
Well, yeah, that's what Southwest Pole. You have a peak down there as well.
Okay. You want to come to the right, and then you're good. I see that. That's money, man. You just got that channel.
Yeah.
Is that four over? Is that coming down together? You just want to ride up on that wave. You want to get over that. So. Get up and you're good. Saddler's better than right side. How would you run that, Simon? What would be your markers? I see this big green wave there.
So, when you're in the boat, you just get down low. And you're boat height. So you can see kind of the rock here dipping down. And you'll see kind of the end of the shoulder there.
Yeah.
And then that is the target you've got at the top here, so you can then...
Simon, I'll just paddle through and
they can
see.
Okay. I would say...
Basically, right. Kind of right in the middle.
Yeah, so, and you can see your two markers there. You get kind of gently in the middle, look for it, and then paddle after. So you see everything coming in.
Oh, he almost echoed to the other side. I didn't start the echo to... Yeah, you're a little bit off.
Yeah, because that water's coming this way, so you want to have a little...
Do
you want to
echo to this way?
You want to go through it, perpendicular really.
Yeah,
yeah.
So I thought you
wanted
to
go
like this,
but it's this. Yeah, but don't forget, and then as soon as you're through, you're wanting to turn left into the eddy.
Yeah. So you want to have like this echo.
You power through this, you'll power right into Phil's.
Yeah, you need to turn. Afterwards, yeah.
So, but that's why I would do an angle like this, not like either of that angle.
Yeah.
I angle that way, I
don't
angle this way.
But, so the wave is going across at an angle here,
yeah.
And you want to hit it perpendicular.
Yeah.
What you don't want to do is end up going into it sideways, yeah? So you want to punch it as soon as you through, bang to the side, paddle to the eddy.
Okay.
So there's two parts to it, through, eddy,
mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Makes sense.
Because if you're going for the eddy early, you're just basically running that sideways. You don't really want to do.
And actually, that key is also a good marker, that fall tree.
Yeah, yeah.
But I usually like better water markers, or like a little bit of pink.
Yeah, a little left edge, yeah, as you go through there.
Just yeah, then don't line that track.
Okay.
Go. What a one of this.
So used to be paddling off that side. We've been in there like every day.
Yeah, like.
I can't promise you that it won't be semi-traumatic if you flip. It shouldn't hurt or anything, but it'd be a new experience. You might be stuck for a second.
Yeah.
I'm comfortable with it. Whether it's good or bad experiences, I'm not. There's no such thing as reality. It's only a perception.
modified. Let's give it a whirl.
Gonna give it a whirl?
Yeah.
He's giving it a whirl. Look, he's got his game face on. Let me check the GoPro.
That's encouraging. Yep.
Stay in the eddy.
Right here, yeah.
You get to give it a hoot and a holler and a smile.
Thank you.
Is it easier to get out at the bottom or at the top?
Whatever.
think it's a one boat eddy. I'll let you guys go ahead. I'll space it out a bit.
He's good paddling.
Good paddle.
I think I got some good exercise this week.
Burned some calories.
This is good.
Kind of like that.
Right. Bladed. Hey. Did you learn new stuff today? Dry head there? Yeah. I focused on doing the back deck roll on this, and I really want to do the dry head in that. I played a bit, but I wasn't playing too much. It's like, that's not what we need to do, and I was all about energy conservation.
I'm very close to doing something else, so I can do like a stall.
Yeah.
But I cannot hold it. It's like I always keep. So I guess like my next step is just like holding
it. I'd only been on a playboat one day before coming here, but I've, you know, you see where I'm at. You know what I mean? But that was a learning curve. I'm like, it was nice to get in the familiar boat today. Comfy.
I guess my
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm doing them. Like, I'm trying them.
I want to. I'm not.
Just like, it looks like. I see the right momentum, you know?
Yep.
Because sometimes it looks like that all.
Dry head kickflip? Like Dane.
And another one, I don't know, probably won't do it
again. Yeah. Have you heard of a mystery move?
Mystery move? Yeah.
Where you kind of go upside down in a boat like this and it catches your nose?
It's just like when you disappear, your boat completely disappears underwater.
Oh, well, I don't know what.
Okay.
Picture I go in a. Macho move, is that where you go in a hole and then flip upside down and it grabs your nose?
No, so macho move, it's like when you do like a...